So today we start with another class of Mendelian inheritance. And last class we had talked about incomplete dominance, codominance and dominance. And we had also understood that if the phenotype of the heterozygote is same as the phenotype of the homozygote, then we have to consider that character to be a dominant character. That is, it is capable of completely masking the recessive character. However, if the phenotype of the heterozygote is intermediate, that is, falls within a range between the phenotypes of the two homozygotes, in this case the red and the white, so the phenotype is intermediate, or in this case it is the purple and then the violet, we get the intermediate, we get a violet intermediate, so purple and white, we get a violet intermediate, then the character exhibits the property of incomplete dominance. And in case of codominance, we had started here and will continue from here, the phenotype of the heterozygote includes the phenotype of both the homozygotes. Another bit of revision I'd like to do it here is that we have talked about alleles earlier to these slides. And now we are moving to a space of codominance where we'll be talking about multiple alleles. Now, we should always remember that regarding the multiple alleles, that alleles are alternative form of a gene. They occupy the same locus on a particular chromosome. First point to be kept in mind. Second, alleles govern the same character of an individual. A haploid cell has a single copy of an allele, diploid two copy of an allele, and the polyploid can have more than two for a character. An individual may have identical alleles at the corresponding locus of homologous chromosome, so that is homozygous, as in A1, A1, or two different alleles, that is heterozygous, as in A1, A2. The alleles may be dominant and recessive, we have studied that, or wild and mutant types. Multiple alleles, now coming to the point of multiple alleles. Multiple alleles always belong to the same locus, and one allele is present at a locus at a time in a chromosome. Multiple alleles always control the same character of an individual. However, the expression of the character will differ depending on the allele present. And usually in a series of multiple alleles, wild type is always dominant. The rest of the allele in the series may exhibit dominance or intermediate phenotypic expression when the two alleles are involved in a clause. So this is about multiple alleles, and we talked about this the other day also. And now we are moving on to our topic for today, where we will start is the perfect example of codominance, and that is seen in case of the blood group system in case of humans. So in case of humans, we have this example of multiple alleles, where in the blood grouping system, we observe this case. Now, we must remember that we have studied immunology, and when we talk about blood group, you have studied that there are four categories of blood group: blood group A, blood group B, AB and O. And talking about the genetics part, if we look into the genetics part, the A blood group has a genotype of IAIA, so IAIA is the gene, or has a genotype of IA small I. The B blood group in this picture has a genotype of IB, IB or IB small I. The AB blood group has a genotype of IA, IB, and the O blood group has a genotype of small I. Now first let us come to the concept of what is the biochemistry behind it. Now the biochemistry behind this is that we have a eight substance precursor. So this is a two sugar molecule, galactose, and we are having galactose amine here. To this molecule, there is one allele, there is one gene, FUT1, FUT1 gene, which adds a fucose molecule. So now you look here. So we have a fucose molecule, we have a galactose molecule, and we have an N-acetyl glucosamine molecule. Okay, these three sugar molecules actually make up the chemical substance which is known as H substance or the H antigen. So this is the structure. Now we are discussing blood group in context to multiple allele and in context to codominance. So keep this in mind. We are studying actually the principle of genetics. So if blood group is governed by three categories of allele, so it's IA. One allele is IA, as you can see here. The other allele is IB. And the third allele is small I. Now, IA allele codes for a protein, which is an enzyme known as glycosyl transferase. IB also codes for an enzyme, which is known as glycosyl transferase. So, both IA and IB allele can code for a protein known as glycosyl transferase, but the enzyme has a difference in its sugar preference. That is, the enzyme coded by IA allele prefers the selection of N-acetyl galactosamine sugar, and the glycosyl transferase coded by IB allele prefers a galactose sugar. Okay, so that is the difference in the sugar preference of the same enzyme. It's the same enzyme glycosyl transferase. For IA, it's different sugar preferred. For IB, it is different sugar preferred. Now let us come to the third allele, that is small I. The small I allele does not code for any product. So it does not code for any enzyme. So we are having three alleles, IA coding for a glycosyl transferase, which is capable of adding a N-acetyl glucosamine sugar. We have a IB allele, which codes for glycosyl transferase, again, which is capable of adding a galactose sugar. While the small I allele, or in many books it is referred to as IO, I superscript O, or the small I allele, does not code for any enzyme. Okay, now let us consider what will happen when we have these three varieties. So this is the H substance precursor, and this is the FUT1 allele. The FUT1 allele helps in addition of fucose, and we have the H substance. So this is the precursor molecule. Now comes the blood group genes. So if we have a IA allele, it will code, as I said, for the enzyme glycosyl transferase, which will add, as you can see, N-acetyl galactosamine to the H substance. Okay. No, it's here, it's adding it here. It's adding a N-acetyl galactosamine to its substrate. So we have the common H antigen, and on that common H antigen, the enzyme coded by the IA allele adds only N-acetyl galactosamine. On the other hand, we have a H substance. You can see the H substance. And on this H substance, if it is a IB allele, it codes for a glycosyl transferase, which adds galactose to the H substance. So this is actually a four chain molecule in which you can see the terminal. This is known as the terminal sugar. In case of IA, the terminal sugar is N-acetylgalactosamine, and in case of IB, the terminal sugar is galactose. This is what makes the difference in the antigen specificity of this molecule. Let's look into this picture. So as you can see, this is the A blood group and this is the H substance. This is the B blood group and this is the H substance of the B blood group. And as you can see, this is the AB blood group. We have the H substance for the A blood group and H substance for the B blood B type. So you can see that the H substance, this is the H sub, this is the O blood group. So you can see the H substance is common. If you look into this picture, if you look into the molecules of the four types, you'll be able to see that the H substance is common for all. Hence, O is the universal donor, because this H substance is present basically in all the surface antigens in the RBC of other blood types. Now what happens, as I said, the N-acetyl, the glycosyl transference of the IA allele actually adds a N-acetyl galactosamine to the molecule. So it's adding an N-acetyl galactosamine, as you can see, and this terminal sugar changes the property of the H substance into the antigen A type. And the IB allele, as I said, the glycosyl transferase from this IB allele as a galactose to the H substance, and as a result this gives rise to the B type antigen from the H substance. Now in case of the AB blood group, we have equal expression of both the A antigen category and the B antigen category, because since IA and IB are codominant, so 50% of the IA will produce glycosyl transferase that will add, as you can see, N-acetyl galactosamine, and 50% of the IB allele will produce that glycosyl transferase that will add galactose to the H substance, as a result of which people having the AB blood group has 50% of their H substance bearing an N-acetyl galactosamine, and 50% of their H substance having a galactose. So on their RBC surface, we have 50% A antigen. If we pull the total RBC of these kind of people, we will be able to see that 50% of the RBC contains 50% of A antigen, and the RBC contains 50% of B antigen, and these people express both the phenotype. So this is a codominant allele. There is no blending of the characters. A antigen is expressed equally as much as the B antigen. There is no range between A to B, and A is equally dominant to B. So this is a perfect example and a case of codominance. Now let us think what happens to persons without the IA allele or the IB allele. Now, as I said, if we move on to the previous picture, so this is the H substance precursor, FUT1 allele adds fructose, and this is the H substance. So people with the small I allele or IO allele combination fails to produce any product. They cannot give any enzyme. They cannot produce any glycosyl transferase. So in absence of glycosyl transferase, what does the O blood group expresses? They expresses only the H substance. Okay. So this is what we observe if we do the checkerboard. So when we have a cross between IA small I and IB small I, then we get IAIB, this is type AB blood group, IA small I. Since I does not code for anything, so the capital I is a haplosufficient gene, and the amount of glycosyl transferase it codes converts the eight substances into the A antigen type. Similarly, IBI, small I. Small I also fails to code anything, as a result of which IB, again being a haplosufficient gene, is enough to convert the eight substances into the B antigen type. And small I are the type O, which do not have any glycosyl transferase enzyme, and thus the A substance is neither converted to the A antigen type or the B antigen type. The A substance stays as it is. So this is the O blood. Now let's come back to this picture. Now let us assume there's an interesting feature or a phenotypic disease known as Bombay phenotype. Now what happens in that case? In case of Bombay phenotype, imagine that there is a mutation in the small I allele. If there is a mutation in the small I allele, we will be getting a defective H substance. So for patients having AB blood group, if an individual has a AB blood group, so he has an IA allele and an IB allele. But since the H substance is defective, the glycosyl transferase from the IA allele or the IB allele fails to recognize this and thus fails to add the terminal sugars. Even though the patient or the individual is having an IA allele and an IB allele, due to defective H substance, the IA allele or the IB allele fails to add terminal sugars. So what we get? We get a phenotype very similar to the O blood group. So individuals with Bombay phenotype, even though they have an AB blood group system, because the H substance itself is defective, no terminal sugar is added. So they exhibit something what is observed in case of O blood group. So this was an interesting case that came up while studying multiple alleles. And since this was first observed in Bombay, this kind of patients were first observed in Bombay, so it is known as Bombay phenotype. So I'm pausing my recording here. So this was one example of a multiple allele which just now I said. And now let's move on to some other examples of multiple alleles, where you can see that this is another example of multiple allele that determines, so we are talking about the M allele, that determines the feather pattern of mallard ducks. So this is a mallard duck, okay? And the M, capital M allele, produces the wild type mallard pattern. So this is the mallard pattern, okay? Now, there are three alleles in this locus. Just keep it in mind, in a two locus, always two alleles it, but the character can be contributed by a number of alleles. Okay. Now, for this mallard pattern, it has been seen that the determines the feather pattern of mallard ducks. For this mallard pattern, there are three alleles to be taken into consideration. One is the capital M allele, which produces the wild type. So see, this is the capital M allele, which produces the wild type mallard pattern phenotype. Then there is a MR allele, this one. So this produces a different pattern known as restricted. You can see this pattern restricted. And there is a third allele for governing that character, that is known as the small MD, which is the dusky type. So we have a small MD, CC. This is the dusky type. So the mallard feather pattern character is in fact governed by three alleles. This is the normal wild type mallard feather pattern. This is the restricted type mallard feather pattern. This is the dusky type mallard feather pattern. The three alleles in consideration are capital M, capital M superscript R and small m superscript D. So these are the three alleles. But these alleles are not codominant alleles. There is a dominance hierarchy in these alleles, as we just now studied one example of multiple allele where A and B are codominant. But keep in mind while doing blood group that capital A is completely dominant over I, small I. That is, the A type is completely dominant over the O type, and the B type is also completely dominant over the O type. But A and B are codominant. This is what we did in our first example. When we move on to our second example, we are seeing that the mallard feather pattern is governed again by three alleles. And the three alleles are not codominant here. There is a definite dominance hierarchy pattern. What does that mean? Now let's look into this dominance hierarchy. So the MR allele is dominant to M, is dominant to MD. So the restricted, the phenotype of the restricted pattern is dominant over the mallard pattern that we see, that we normally see. Birders have seen the mallard ducks. And that is again dominant over the dusky pattern. So let me give you a beautiful equation which tells us that depending on the number of alleles, how many phenotypes can be observed in an individual for a given gene. Allele is nothing but the alternative form of a gene. A gene can be expressed by multiple characters. A gene can have multiple alternative forms. So a gene can exist in multiple allelic forms. So if a gene has three alleles, then how can we deduce how many phenotypes can be observed? So just look at this formula. For example, in this case we are seeing that the feather pattern is governed by three alleles. So instead of N, put 3 there. So it is 3 into 4. This N is 3 here. So there are 3 alleles. So N 3. Within bracket we get 3 plus 1, 4. That is 4 into 3, 12. Divided by 2, 6. So you can see we are observing 6 phenotypes. So this is one easy way of understanding that we have, say for example, when we will be seeing the example of isoallele, you will be seeing that the Drosophila white gene has so many alleles. So how many genotypes can be observed? This is an easy way of calculating the number of genotypes that we can get based on the number of alleles available at a definite locus. Now coming to this expression type, as you can see from the dominance hierarchy format that mallard restricted, dominant to mallard type, dominant to mallard dusky type. Now, when we have a homozygous MR-MR, it is a restricted. And in the dominance hierarchy, MR is completely dominant to M. Now, this dominance hierarchy is not about incomplete dominance. It is a hierarchy of complete dominance. So we have to assume that MR is completely dominant to M. M is completely dominant to MD. So MR-MR homozygous, we get a restricted phenotype. MR-M heterozygous, we get a restricted phenotype. Again, MR-MD restricted phenotype. Since MR is completely dominant to both M and to MD. Now coming to MM. That is mallard. As M is dominant over MD, so MM mallard. Again, as M is completely dominant over MD, MMD mallard. And finally, the most recessive of the lot, MDMD dusky. So this is another example of multiple allele through the mallard pattern. So as you can see, if we cross a mallard heterozygous mallard restricted type with a heterozygous mallard type, so with the gamete segregate and then fertilization, and you can see we get 1/4 heterozygous mallard restricted. So this is both a heterozygous mallard restricted, but see the combination of the genotype. MRM 1/4, MRMD 1/4. Phenotypically, we will not be able to identify whether this heterozygous has a M allele or a MD allele. Now, coming to the Mallard, we have a 1/4 MMD, that's a Mallard type, and we have a 1/4 Dusky type. Now, where is that example? I didn't give that rabbit example. Okay, we'll come to that later on. Now, so we have studied about the multiple alleles. I give you an example of multiple alleles and a case of codominance. I have given you a case of multiple alleles, but here the alleles are completely dominant over each other and how they are expressed. And we have also studied that if there are n equals to the number of different alleles at a locus, then how do we determine the number of genotypes present at a locus? So we have studied that also. Now coming to the concept of complementation. Now when we talk about the concept of complementation, we have to keep in mind that this is an experiment done to deal that whether two mutations belong to the same gene or the two mutations belong to different gene. So this is a cis-trans test for allelism. That is, whether they are allelic or whether they are non-allelic. So that is the test of complementation. And in this particular example, as you can see, but before that, let me tell you that alleles may be arranged in two types. One type is known as the cis configuration and the other type is known as the trans configuration. For example, when both the wild type, for example, plus plus, if this chromosome had both the wild type alleles, then it would have been a cis configuration. And if this chromosome had both the mutant alleles, then it would have been a trans configuration. But in this particular picture, there is not a single case of cis configuration. All configurations are that of trans configurations. Now, let us assume that there are two alleles, MA and MB. The experiment is to determine that whether the MA mutant and the MB mutant, whether they belong to the same gene or whether they belong to two different genes. So, MA and MB are two mutant alleles. The concept is to develop that whether they belong to the same gene, whether they are the alleles of gene 1 or they are two different alleles, one for gene 1 and the other for gene 2. So what is done? Case 1, assuming that the mutants are in separate genes. If the mutations are in separate genes, we have two genes in consideration, gene 1, gene 2. So, MA is a mutant of gene 1, MB is a mutant of gene 2. When there is crossing over, we get a normal copy of gene 2 and we get a normal copy of gene 1. So, complementation occurs. We get two wild type copies. Since we have two wild type copies, we get a wild type fly. So complementation has occurred. Okay, so there was crossing over and we got a wild type set and the complementation has occurred. This wild type has complemented with this wild type. But if the mutations are in different locations of the same gene, that is the mutations are allelic, the mutations belong to the same gene. So this is a MA mutant, the mutation present in gene 1. This is a MB mutant. Here also, the location is different, but it is a mutation present in gene 1. So the mutations are allelic. Okay? They belong to the same gene. When we do a cross like this, as you can see, since gene 1 is mutated in this fly, as a result of presence of MA mutation, and gene 1 is mutated in this fly as a result of MB mutation. So whenever we inherit one of the chromosomes from either of the parents, you see that the gene one is mutated. It has either a MA mutant in one chromosome and a MB mutant in another chromosome. So gene one is defective. We do not get a wild type phenotype. So no complementation occurs. And what is the inference? Inference that is that the mutations are allelic. The mutations belong to the same gene. The mutations are alleles of the same gene. So this is an example for cis-trans test of allelism. I'll show you one example, but right now I'll stop the recording here.